So we see people just feel to go out there and do more and want to go out there and accomplish things. And the thing is, when you start doing ministry outside of the four walls, I'm talking about being ready in season, out of season, you realize that there's an old saying that people says that people don't care what you know until they know that you care. We also live in a society where people feel, you know, what have you done for me lately? I appreciate your prayers. I'm glad that you're praying for me. But you, Christian, what resources, what information do you have? What connections can you help me with this situation that I'm dealing with right now? Maybe they don't come to your church. What can you do? What work will you have? That's the reason why we have to be prepared, because we never know whose path we're going to cross. And God is saying everything that you're going through, it's not about you. And I know that sometimes we want to own the emotions, we want to own the experience, but God is saying that He's such a big God. He's saying, I'm stepping all the way down in your tomorrow, in your next year, in the years after that. And God is saying, what you're going through right now, it's not for you, it's to mature you, it's to get you a little bit more solidified in your faith, because somebody's going to come by who is downtrodden, someone's going to need restoration, and I need you to be ready.
Yes.
But you can't be ready if you're not prepared.
Yes.
The series that I want to talk about is Master My Moments. You think about life, and life can be broken down into just a series of just moments. Things you got right, things that you got wrong, times you went to the left, sometimes you went to the middle, sometimes you went to the right. I think about moments in my life, getting married, having kids, graduating, buying a home, starting a business, or going into ministry, or starting a job, or losing a job, and going to school, all these things. And I ask you today is, how are you preparing for your moment? The moment that you don't know what's coming, that you don't see, how are you preparing now for your moment? Like the scripture says, so my goal today is to convince, rebuke, and exhort with long suffering and teaching. If I could just convince you that God has a plan for your life and you believe that, then we're good.
Yeah.
If I could just rebuke those who are ready to throw in a towel and give up, if I could just rebuke those and put them on the right path, then you're good. If I could just exhort everyone today and say, in spite of what you're going through, please just continue to move forward, then we will be in really good shape. And understand that God does have a plan. That you are not forgotten. That you are on His radar. That He is concerned about whatever is impacting you. I'm not oblivious to the concerns that we have. God, how are you going to do it? God, I have needs. God, this is going on. God, I have loss. God, there's so much devastation. God, there's people who are hopeless out there. God, I don't know what to do. There's just so much uncertainty. And I'm reminded that in Psalms 138:8, it said the Lord will perfect that which concerns me. Your mercy, O Lord, endures forever. Do not forsake the work of your hands. So God's saying, you're concerned about something? You're my people, you're concerned about something? God's saying, I can use that. You don't know how you're going to make it? God's saying, I can use that as part of my plan. Everything that's plaguing you, that's concerning, God's saying, I can perfect that. I'm going to perfect everything that concerns you. God's saying, I take your concern. I hear the worry. I hear the stress. I hear the strain. But if your faith is in God, you should not be moved. Know that everything that you're going through did not catch Him by surprise. I'm just really excited that I deserve a schizophrenic God who forgets what he said, forgives him. Are yes and amen.
Yes.
He's the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Yes.
God is saying He's taking all those concerns. And He's making a masterpiece of those things that are concerning you.
Thank you, Lord.
It's all about the preparation.